We've had one or two conversations with our regulator at Ofsted, monitoring visit, but also our annual conversation. That's an interesting and very transparent conversation, so they have a view about how much progress we've made. And also in terms of external, internal, what the rest of the council thinks about how we are hitting on. The internal view is mainly based upon what our staff are saying. So how do our frontline practitioners, our first-line managers, see progress? What have they said about that and how are they going to do it? And I'll throw in a little bit there about personal view, which is really easy for me to do at this stage because I can still have plausible denial. I've only been here for about 7 weeks. Last time I went for 6 weeks, we thought it was 5 weeks after about 4 weeks in. That would send me a long enough. It's a personal view, and it's also based on experience, rather than not just in the world of other places. The acid question, or the acid test is, what difference have we made so far in the lives of children? A lot of what we do in this year around improvement isn't necessarily going to be measurable in terms of the impact on children, because it's basically everything. The data is in the right place, the ducks lined up, everyone message, and then you go up to the impact on children. And then finally, the feedback is also based upon the burning platform of well, how long have we actually got there to improve children's services? And the short answer is we don't know. What we should expect, what we could be re-expecting any time from September this year. So we're working on the basis of that in September, so what's that? Half months now, we've sat 38 months, but it's getting towards the end of January. So, these are the conditions that I'm referring to, and testing this out in terms of the short-term progress that we've made. Is there a clear vision, which basically might not mean something behind the scales, sort of like we do our best and help everybody. It's a vision for what we need to do individually and collectively, and what it is we're trying to do, and why those things are important. And that vision has to be very much at this stage of the improvement journey focused on the practice that's evident in individual casework. I think there's a bit of work to do on this, but there is an understanding about the direction of the move towards why we need to change the way that to some extent we've made in the past. And in terms of the focus on practice, there's lots of messaging going into practice around expectations and standards and accountability. So if you wanted to start from 1 to 10, where are we with the vision and the focus on improvement? We're probably over halfway there, 6 or 7. So it's a good start, but with a bit more to do. So for example, we will be working with our practitioners in the near future all service workshop about asking three questions. What do I have to do to improve my practice? What do I need from my manager to improve my practice? And what do I need from my partners? And that becomes an individual set of statements that we can then collect together, and that will then become the kind of golden thread for the individual people. Ensuring that we have the right number and quality of practitioners to live good outstanding practice and become an employer of choice. Well, you know some of this story from previous updates about the agency issues, there's lots of agency workers, and we've had some issues around recruitment. There's been a significant amount of work done on remodeling the offer to the market, if you like, the market that we need to play into. There's an active campaign on the way that we're around recruitment, and we've had the recruitment events lined up at the end of the 7th and 8th and 8th and 9th of February, which is the first wave, really, of the impact of that approach. We have the resources, there's no doubt about that. We know what the numbers are. Our challenge is about quality and making sure that we've got quality at every level. That's a work in progress. And I'd say, yeah, look at the 1 to 10, I'd put that personally around about a 5. So, a lot better, but quite a bit to do. And the bit to do is about quality, the quality of individuals in the organisation. The absolute clarity about who does what, lines of accountability, and that the accountability conversations held with a relatively small group of individuals who don't necessarily like messaging. So this is a quite a well advanced piece of the mechanics about the architecture for the approval. We're in a hard end now where we're pulling at complaints from the individual. And what we would be offering them is opportunities to improve. But what we can't offer them is opportunities not to improve. So at the end of the day, so as I say, we're at that point. There's a lot of the improvement work starts at your first contact with your family. So we talk about the front door, and can we evidence that our partners and our own staff understand what the thresholds are for their engagement, so we don't get the wrong children in the wrong place at the wrong time, and those thresholds need to be fully understood on a multi-agency basis and managed on a multi-agency basis. That the actions that we take to keep children safe are timely, focused on the child, and of high quality. This is an area where there's been significant improvement. I want to summarise that, I would say what we know where we are in terms of the improvement journey, we are not yet in a position where we can say if Ofsted came back tomorrow, we would get significantly different or better outcomes from inspection. We know what we need to do to improve those outcomes, and we've got about 8.5 months. So there's an urgency about the next phase of improvement, which is all about focusing on a small number of really critical areas of improvement work, which is really about sitting there and talking to practitioners about what they're coaching into good practice. So the monitoring visit that took place in December, which as I said, the letters were published on the website. The focus of that was a very specific of 6 cases looked at in relation to children over the age of 11. We've been in care for a long time. The care plan for those children, the PEPs, so the personal education plan, the strength of difficulty questionnaire, which tells us about the emotional well-being of those children, access to advocacy and independent visitor. And the letter sort of is a little bit scatty in terms of some of these things, because I think what we were, if I was to go back, was to say the advocacy and independent visitor is significantly better than it was. The presence of children with questionnaires and PEPs is significantly better than it was. Question mark, quality, and whether people fully understand the significance of these things. Care planning, variable, and remember the cohort cases, long-term care, which means that they can look right the way back. They're not looking at what we've been in the last 3 months, they're looking at what we've been in the last 10 years or some children. And there was some pre-core practice in some of those cases. So overall, the message that we got was that there is, I want to just quote myself here, some progress. That the progress has been slow, but now it is gathering momentum and the progress is more promising. So, the findings were mixed in terms of quality. It weren't honest, which we are always honest. Given that we're 18 months into inspection, there's an expectation that we should be a bit further on. But we know that, so it's not a surprise to us looking at that, and no one's going to make excuses about that. We just need to be more focused in the next 3 to 6 months. And that the big challenge